Hello all, this is Dr. Alsop, and I have a real short vignette regarding the lymph nodes found in the submandibular and submental cervical triangle regions, and fortunately the names of the lymph nodes match up perfectly to the corresponding triangle name, so let's take a look at an image. So we're looking at an inferior lateral view, and let's identify structures that we already know. Of importance here is your digastric muscle. I'm going to just kind of outline where this is located. You can see it here, that's going to be the anterior belly, this will be the posterior belly back here. So you know that you're looking into that submandibular triangle region. Here is also going to be part of the submandibular gland, which has been cut some in order to be able to see the lymph nodes a little bit better. So, this is exactly within the submandibular triangle, this is where those submandibular lymph nodes will be located. There are typically three lymph nodes here. One is typically anterior to the submandibular gland, which you can see here. And then you will have, and note that the lymph node is typically darker than and separate from the gland. So that's how you can kind of tell the difference between those. The other two lymph nodes are located on either side of the facial artery. So here I'm going to kind of outline the facial artery here. So you can see one here, a lymph node here, and a lymph node right here. So on either side of that facial artery. So many much smaller and not visible lymph vessels from a wide variety of areas will drain into these submandibular lymph nodes, such as vessels from the nose or the cheek, some from the upper and lower lip regions are all draining towards these lymph nodes. All right, looking more into the submental triangle region, you can see a submental lymph node right about here-ish. These lymph nodes will drain structures from the submental triangle or on the inferior portion of the mylohyoid muscle, and it will drain lymph either into the submandibular lymph nodes or into the jugulo-omohyoid nodes, which are going to be a bit more inferior. All right, so I told you this would be a shorter one, and I think as long as you feel comfortable with your cervical triangle subdivisions, you should be able to name the lymph nodes by this. As always, feel free to reach out to me with any questions, and thank you for your time and attention.